Candiss Williams demonstrates a passion for research that takes all of the soil functions and makes them understandable and makes them accessible by models and by researchers.
I'm interested in the processes that happened at the field scale. So the tools that I use are edge of field and landscape models. And what I mean by edge of field represents the area that connects the upland fields to, say, a water body or a water source. And my interest in edge of field is because how we manage the land impacts what leaves the land that we're managing the fields. Some of the models that I'm interested in are like crop models, because we're interested in how the land is managed and how it impacts soil properties. So the scale is a lot smaller than someone who's interested in looking at a large water basin, or, you know, they're interested in looking at, you know, the continental U.S.
And who are the people that use the results of the models in your research?
Okay. The end users are planners, policymakers, researchers. For NRCS, we have a group called the Conservation Effects Assessment Program Modeling Team. And one of their jobs is to quantify the benefits of conservation programs on the landscape. And updates that I make to the models, evaluation of the updates, that information is used because they use that to make reporting at the national level about how USDA dollars are benefiting water quality and soil quality.
So they can actually quantify the effects of sediment transport and nutrients within that sediment on water bodies?
Correct. So with these tools, to efficiently evaluate the benefits of conservation programs, it requires monitoring. And with limited resources, simulation tools are really beneficial because you can use information that you have collected, and you're able to simulate or predict what will happen either somewhere else on the landscape, or you could look at long-term benefits. And with these tools, it actually provides a number. It quantifies the massive sediment being lost to surface water or being transported across the landscape, whether it's from the top of a slope down to the toe slope bottom area, or it quantifies concentrations of nitrogen, phosphorus, even pesticides that are moving across or even leaving the landscape. So that's one of the benefits, because it's easier to predict. You can get the information quicker, and from that you can use that information to do long-term planning. So that's one of the benefits of using tools such as those, where you can use them to predict long-term effects of conservation programming.
Tell me about the National Soil Survey Center itself. What does that represent to you?
To me, the National Soil Survey represents a think tank, and also a place where people from around the world can come for resources. We are a resource center.
Candiss represents that new generation of soil scientists that relates so well to the research community and is able to work with those people that are studying the environment and looking at soil as a possible transport of nutrients to our water. And our water in the United States is better because of this research.